Descends on North America, things can get pretty tough. So can its winter sport. Sport on ice was a common feature of every European winter. In Holland, they played golf. And in Scandinavia and Britain, a stick and ball game like field hockey called bandy. The game is still played in Northern Europe and is currently experiencing a revival. Harsh Canadian winters were even more suitable for winter diversions than those of Europe. In the 19th century, huge ice festivals were held in the large cities. In Montreal, students at McGill University played a game on ice just like bandy, but with a crucial difference. They used a flat puck, easier to control on ice than a ball. And with this very simple change, ice hockey was born. McGill students staged the first competition in 1879, and the game, perfect for Canada's climate, spread rapidly. By 1893, there was a championship, the Lord Stanley of Preston Cup. The game was by now played throughout Canada, and it spread into the United States. But its home was French-speaking Montreal and Quebec. It would be North American sports' French connection.
I think for Montreal, for the entire population of the province of Quebec, and especially for the Montreal Canadiens, it's like a religion.
The Canadiens have won huge fame worldwide. The reason is their enormous success since their foundation, all the championships and the Stanley Cup.
You never forget the first game you play. It's just a dream to play for the Canadiens.
Les Canadiens were the Quebecois sporting heroes. The greatest player of the first half of the century was Howie Morenz. He dominated the centre of the ice for the Canadiens for 14 years, until in 1937 he broke his leg during a game. 6 weeks later, he died from complications. Thousands mourned his passing. But Maurice the Rocket Richard was the king of the Canadiens' golden age. In the 50s, they won five consecutive Stanley Cups. The Rocket was the greatest goal scorer the sport had seen. In an 18-year career, he scored 544 goals for his beloved club. The last one, the winning goal in the 1960 championship. The mantle was then passed to his brother Henri the Pocket Rocket Richard, who won another six championships. But hockey wasn't just a Quebec love affair. King Clancy and the Toronto Maple Leafs were great rivals, and Clancy was a fearsome opponent. In more recent times, there have been other outstanding players. Bobby Orr of Boston, Montreal's Guy Lafleur, and Chicago's Bobby Hull, the ageless Gordie Howe, Mike Bossy, who took the New York Islanders to four Stanley Cups, and Mario Lemieux of Pittsburgh. All are stars, but only one man is referred to as the Great One.
Light years ahead in his thinking, and every bit as great an individual as a champion on the ice. He's just a super kid.